I'll make it all come true.
We were on a trip to a city called San Diego, but before then, we stopped by at a McDonald's for breakfast. I was actually kind of excited about that because I've wanted to try the new sauces they have for collaborating with BTS. Haven't tried the, I hope I pronounced this correctly, Kaechoon sauce. But I was able to try the sweet chili one, and I liked it. Next, we took a bathroom break at our family friend's
home. This is the most smoothest toilet I've ever experienced.
Yep. I'm glad there are decent toilets around. Most end up being either loud or too weak to handle human waste. And when I tell you I have stomach problems, you can probably understand my pickiness for bathrooms. Arriving in San Diego, we visited this Fleet Science Center in Balboa Park. Not gonna lie, the experience did feel disappointing as much as I didn't want to. Admit it, after paying expensive tickets, there are quite a few fun exhibits, I'll tell you that. Ranging from astronomy to the different types of energy sources. Of course, I've already been taught this. So this museum was really for little children. After those exhibits, we decided to watch a film that was included in our fleet experience. It's called The Great Bear Rainforest, which truthfully felt like there was some misinformation in it, other than perhaps one interviewee with her bear for a research team. I mean, I can't tell whether those people legitimately don't know anything about the rainforest and are just spitting filler sentences, or that they actually are knowledgeable in the subject. But I'm not an expert, so I can't confirm that. Afterwards, the gift shop. I stayed by the bear category and not the rocks or quote-unquote mystical stones, because I know how much of a scam they are. Exiting the museum, we took a ride on trolley. No wait, it's a tram. We simply wanted to look around before heading to a garden, only to find that it was closed. Then we left the park. Nice water lilies though. Next up is Little Italy, apparently highly recommended on the internet. I've actually wanted to visit a restaurant there, but considering how crowded it is, we opted to check in at our hotel instead. It was beautiful and modern in architecture. Walking in it makes me feel more broke than ever. Unfortunately, there was no available room, and I was getting both impatient and hungry. So we bought and ate some snacks from the hotel's market. It bamboozled me to find out that you have to have a credit card in order to buy food. It's understandably expensive, but really, are the usual dollar bills not easy for you to count and secure high at? I would have thought it takes a simple bank account for your status and basic math. Shame on you, but at least the burger sandwich was good and filling. Finally, we got a hotel room. The view was amazing. Wasn't too sure about the other Hyatt building blocking the rest of it, but I suppose it's sufficient. Color me happy to see that a seagull came to visit us. Or did it want food? I couldn't tell, and it's probably safe not to feed it any. It did linger around for a long time until I was told to scare it away for my cousin's satisfaction of getting a bird to spread its wings on camera. Getting ready to swim because my period cycle is finally over after a continuous 2 months. Oh, that's right. I can't forget to introduce a new friend of mine. Meet the bear. I couldn't come up with a decent name, so if you have any ideas, feel free to let me know. Fast forward, we got to Little Italy, and a restaurant I've been wanting to go to after around a mile's walk. We had to wait a while, and I was sure my cousins had doubts on this restaurant. If you're wondering, it's called Philippi's Pizza Grotto. I was admittedly saddened to realize that they were right. I mean, looking from their perspective, the wait was incredibly long and boring. The food had a lot of tomato sauce, and that fell under my cousin's standards. I thought it would satisfy everyone, but I guess I don't know my family as much as I wanted, so that's a huge blow on my ego. I genuinely liked the food, besides the fact that one lasagna is the literal size of my head. And again, the tomato sauce, I will agree with them on that. In the end, I rate this experience personally a 7 out of 10 cheese sticks. We took another long walk back to the hotel, passing by some sort of community campout with full stomachs and aches from running across the street. The lights are beautiful at night. And side note, I have the small wish that I would be able to look at the city from the top of the tall building to admire the lighting and get that full main character traveling adventure experience. But it's probably gonna take a long time before that actually happens. Yeah. Here you can see me shedding the tears out of my eyes over forgetting my Genshin password for the primal gems that I could have had for Kazuha if it weren't for my stupidity. At least the crying helped me sleep better. May all your dreams be sweet tonight, safe upon your sleep. The sun rose, birds tweet, and stomachs are ready to feast. We walked down to the breakfast buffet where it's surprisingly empty. Then again, it's a Sunday. We picked our foods and seated ourselves at one of the outdoor tables. I think that confirms that my cousins are introverts or they hate people. I love breakfast foods. They're always fresh and the flavors blend well, unlike the typical lunch or dinner meals. I have buttermilk pancakes, scrambled eggs, some potatoes, sausages, and bacon, along with a cream cheese pastry, and they're really good. The buffet also has custom omelets, and the one I had tastes great. But I realized that the many different toppings basically oppose each other's flavors. So to summarize it, if confusion was an omelet. Also, hey, another seagull, but I don't think it likes being on camera. I got another plate, this time of fruits with another of those pastries. Seriously, I recommend the cream cheese one. Oh, and I shouldn't forget about how there's raw salmon there. I practically grinned at seeing it. After that, we walked by the ships, get some fresh air, and returned to visit the hotel gym. Only to discover that the pool was reserved for the 4th of July. Only guests with red wristbands were able to enter. So I was tasked with getting them from the front desk because we all wanted to take a swim before we leave. But I was told that the guests who are sleeping in on the 4th are the ones that are able to get the wristbands. Perhaps I should have asked, are we allowed to be in the pool before we check out of the hotel today? That probably would have been more helpful, considering how puzzled I was when I saw that my cousins just got ready to swim. And let's just say we had a bit of an argument over the logic and comprehension of our permission to swim in a pool. Fast forward and we see our seagull friend returned, possibly to bid us farewell and pose for the cameras. It flopped off, then it returned again, then it left. About 15 to 10 minutes before 11 a.m., my cousins and I went to the higher floors for sightseeing pictures. We were fortunate enough to have one of the guests up there to generously let us in their room to get a better city view. Thanks a bunch, ma'am and sir. Checking out, we walked to the nearby seaport village to look at the shops. It was crowded and hot, but we persevered against the bothersome humans and managed to get a birthday present for our grandfather. And yes, we came across a Trump 2024 flag. Those old people and delusional adults seriously have an obsession. Here we go, come with me. There's a world out there that we should see. Take my hand, close your eyes.
Go! if you really want it. Got a jet pack with your name on it. Above the clouds in the atmosphere. Just say the words and we out of here. Hold my hand if you're feeling scared. We're flying up, up, out of here.
Here we go.
End this off, I'd like to say thanks for watching, and I truly appreciate the 200 subscribers as well as the love and support on my other videos or edits. I wanted to get this video out before making another edit that'll take up some space with the character scenes. Again, thank you everyone. I hope you stay sane, stay safe, and that you have a great day. Bye.